Yes, sir.
All power to you, John. Very good.
Fiddle player in olden days, of course it was a way back in, I suppose, the 18th century or thereabout. His name was Anthony Hilberty. And he was going to play at a party, and it came on a wild storm evening, and he had a mountainous road to go, and there was only the one house on the roadside as he on the journey he was going. So the poor soul, the storm came that rapid that he had to retreat and go into this house on the roadside. Well, there was a large family there, and there wasn't a big lot of accommodations, you know, there in them days. So the eldest boy of the family was very anxious to play the fiddle, and he knew that Anthony was a good fiddler. So the boy insisted that Anthony might remain overnight and that he might have the opportunity of learning a new tune. Mm-hmm. Oh, but dear, the mother says, sure, you know, all beds are filled up and, you know, we have a large family, and how, where do we put him? Oh, the boy says, leave that to me now, I'll see about that. The boy began to make a makeshift kind of a bed. As the boy was making the bed, Anthony was making the tune. So when the bed was finished, the tune was made. So now Anthony says, young boy, he says, here's a tune now that you'll have, that no other boy in this area will have but yourself. And the name we're going to call it now is the Four Posts of the Bed, and here goes the tune.
Good man, John.
Thank you.
man, John. Good man, John.
It's
a fine job.
It's called the Fantastic Reel. This old same fiddle player that I talked about there a moment ago, his name was Anthony Helferty. Well, he was a good old fiddler indeed at the time. He happened to be playing at a wedding party, and of course in those days there were nothing going but potching. And Anthony took potching all night, of course, and in the morning he was coming home along the seashore, and he felt drowsy a bit and fatigued less or more. And he sat down on a rock and he fell asleep, the poor fellow, and the fiddling case was beside him. And he heard the sea all night lulling, lulling and lulling and lulling, out and in and out and in. And had given the impression of this tune that I'm going to play now, and the name he called it in the Gaelic language was Thumna Farica. That's the Atlantic roar. So here it goes. Thank you.
Lovely.
This is an old reeler called Miss Ramsey.
Go
Thank you.
happened when I was a boy, around about 16 years of age or 17. You see, our people, they played at all balls and dances and on weddings all over the country here. Mm-hmm. And of course, there was a great session of fiddle playing in Glencolumbkill at that time, weddings, dances, and all the rest. So we were coming out one fine day, we were just going back home to Glenfinn. And we had our fiddles and cases with us coming out, walking from Glencolumbkill. Of course, there was no other transport, you see. There was no way of travelling those days except to heel and toe. So we were coming out that long, lonely road there. I should come from Cashel and Glencolumbkill on out towards Carrick. But anyhow, two of the boys said, "Ah, we'll make the road short. We'll take out the fiddles, or two fiddles, and we'll play a few good reels coming down the road." I got they took out the two fiddles anyhow. And this was the first reel they played. This one I'm at the playing tracks. So my uncle, my mother's brother, he was a good fiddle player, tell the truth. And says, "See, boys, it's too bad there isn't a name for that tune. Not a name for that tune." "Well," said the other man, said, "I'll tell you what we'll do. We'll call it. We'll call it the Glen Road to Carrick." And that's the name it has to this day.
Thank you. Tony, Dan. Lovely, Dan.
Great, Tony.
Lovely!
Great! I'm just beginning to take it out of her now.